Look, I'm just gonna get straight to the point. This is usually the part where I would introduce the video, discuss why the video will be scary, and tell you to stick around until the end of the video where I'll be responding to your comments, something that you should definitely do. However, an incident occurred this weekend that you guys deserve to know about. It involves me, a group of friends, and a Ouija board. That's right. I used a Ouija board for the first time this weekend, and I am now a believer. Not only did it answer questions that we didn't know the answers to, it moved by itself when our hands weren't even near the planchette. I still have chills. Seriously, I'm spooked. Anyway, enough of that. Closets can be scary. Dark holes in the wall that hold your junk and at night reveal truly ominous sights that have left people frightened for years to come. So today on Top 5 Scary Videos, we're going to be counting down the top 5 scary things found in closets. Let's jump in.
I saw her face.
Coming in at 5, Gnome in the Closet. Uploaded to Mysterious Universe by Brent Swanser, he states, "Stories of strange things in the closet come from all over and take many forms. One account from 1952 seems to involve some sort of gnome, which would come out of the closet at night to terrorize a young boy named Dan Bortko from Kansas. The family had moved to a two-story home on a rural farm, complete with a barn. And from a very young age, Bortko claims he frequently saw a small humanoid about 3 feet tall and fully cloaked out in German lederhosen, and with a smoking pipe, lurking about the house, often appearing in his room at night, and frequently stepping out of the closet." Bortko stated, I quote, "I had just awoken from a nap and was rubbing my eyes and saw what you would call a troll. I'll call him a troll because that's what he reminded me of. It was an old man with a long beard, large nose, about 3 feet tall, standing at the foot of my bed. And I was astounded." I think it's safe to say we're all astounded. In at 4, The Rocking Horse. Uploaded to Reddit by Hearside, they discuss how one night when they were 10 or 11, they were having trouble falling asleep. I quote, "My bedroom was the entire top floor of our house, with my bed and such being on the left side and the storage closets and a play area being on the right. I was laying in bed when I heard a noise from the other side of the room and see a rocking horse begin to rock. It was sitting just outside one of my closet doors. It proceeded to rock its way halfway across the room and stopped dead under the ceiling light. At this point I was freaking out and just buried my head under the blankets and never peeked out again until morning. Now this is slightly cheating because it happened just outside of the closet, but I'm counting it because it's just straight up terrifying. Thanks to horror movies, rocking horses are scary enough. Now give them the ability to move freely and that shit is just straight up possessed. No thank you. Not into it." Coming in at number 3, The Bedroom Closet. This story comes to us from Scary for Kids and tells the story of a time a kid's parents went out and they were forced to babysit their little brother. I quote, "We were alone in the house and decided to play a game of hide and seek. Closed my eyes and counted to 20 while my brother ran off to hide. When I finished counting, I started looking around for my brother. I couldn't find him anywhere. I went to my parents' bedroom and noticed the door of their closet was standing ajar. I know you're in there, I shouted as I pulled the door open. The bedroom closet was crammed full of clothes and when I thrust my hand into it, another hand immediately reached out from inside and grabbed me by the wrist. Come on, I found you, I cried, trying to pull him out. Come out of there. But he wouldn't come out no matter how hard I pulled. He was hiding behind all the clothes and didn't speak a word. Started wondering what was wrong with him. Just then, I heard a voice behind me ask, what are you doing? I turned around and was shocked to see my little brother standing in the doorway of the bedroom. Looking back, I realized the pale white hand was still holding onto my wrist. I screamed out loud and began to panic as I desperately tried to shake myself free of its icy grip. My brother rushed over to help me and eventually I managed to squirm out of the clutches of the pale white hand. We ran screaming from the room and rushed out of the house. Standing in the street together, trembling, we waited for our parents to return. When they finally came home, we told them what had happened, and they went upstairs to search the bedroom. Of course, they found nothing inside, just a bunch of old clothes. Spooky, very spooky. Coming in at 2, The Boogeyman. Uploaded to Did You Know Facts, this story describes the time a journalist was told a very interesting true crime story by a woman. It goes, when this woman was a young girl, say 8 years old, she started to come downstairs at night to tell her father that there was a man in her closet. He tells her there's no such thing as the boogeyman and sent her back to her bed. This happens on and off for like a week. Finally, he gets frustrated and walks her back to the room and says, I'll show you there's nothing in your closet, and goes to open the door. It opens an inch and then he feels someone slam it shut. Turns out there really was a man in her closet. This guy was a perv who would come into the house every night and stare at the girl from the closet while she slept. The dad kicked the shit out of him and the perv went to prison for many years. I researched her story 20 years after this happened. The guy had just gotten out of jail again and no one could find him. So spooky. And lastly, coming in at number 1, The house on Acorn Street. Now this one's a long one, but an interesting one nonetheless. Uploaded again to Did You Know Facts. I quote, "When I was 14, my family and I fell on hard times. We got kicked out of our house and ended up in emergency housing. Basically, we went to charity who found us a house that we were able to rent for $100 a month, but only for 3 months. That summer, my mum and stepdad separated temporarily, and my three younger siblings would go to my stepdad's for a week or so, then come back to my mum and me. This house was f***ing creepy. Started off with just that feeling, you know? Like something isn't quite right, that you might not be the only person in the room. In the day, that's all it was, the feeling that something was up, your instincts pricking at you. I tried to ignore it, but as soon as dusk arrived, shit would start happening. More than once, I could hear the static-filled music playing, but I couldn't find the source, it just filled the halls. I heard whispering and went to my two sisters' room. In the open closet, a pair of eyes looked at me and disappeared. My brother spent one night in the house and didn't come back. In my room, I could never win. On one wall, there was a mirror. When I flipped over to face the window, I watched tall shadow figures pace in front of it. In my mother's room, the same shadow figures paced in circles around her room. One night, she and I sat up for 2 hours in her bed watching these shadows. She was strongly religious and didn't know what to make of it. During the time we lived there, there was a lunar eclipse. I had never seen one before and was very excited for it. When I went out to look, every time, this terror took over me and I couldn't stay outside. I couldn't explain it. When the moon was fully cloaked, I went outside, looked up, but my head suddenly snapped down to my left. I could see three tall shadows walking in between the tall pine trees in the yard. Panicked, I ran back inside and into my room, flinging myself under the covers with my eyes shut tightly, but listened to the pacing outside my bedroom window. 3 months of this, we moved out at the end of the summer into a new house. My mum and stepdad got back together, and I was with younger siblings again. We all agreed the house on Acorn Street was fucked up and still get chills when we drive by it. Just to see. This is like Haunting of Hill House levels and I'm terrified. The eyes in the closet, the spooky shadows, what do you guys think? Haunting or trick of the light? You tell me. Well, there we have it. Do you guys agree with our list? Were there any creepy stories that we missed? Leave us all your thoughts and feelings in the comments down below and perhaps we can do a part 2. Before we go, I just want to respond to a few comments from one of our last videos. Top 5 Friendliest SCPs Part 2. DC Carter said, I feel like Lucy could read your thoughts. Time to do a list on top 5 scariest things about Lucy. Just 5? I think I deserve a top 10 at least. Leave me comments down below with your scary facts about me. The more creative, the better. I'll read them out in the next video. From Atlantis said, Lucy though. Why though? Nikki Valentine said, Hey Lucy, thought I'd take a moment to say that I know a lot of people think you're cold, distant, and mechanical, but I don't really see that. Most only see things at face value and avoid looking past that. If they did, they'd realize not all things are what they appear to be, and they shouldn't judge a book by the cover. Anyway, I really enjoyed this channel and think that you and Jack are both amazing hosts. Keep up the good work. Well, shucks, you're very sweet. Don't worry about me, I embrace the comments and play up to what people think of me. Also, for the most part, what you see is the persona I want you to see. I live for that. But again, thank you. And on that note, if you haven't already, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you never miss another scary vid. And until next time, see you later.